Hey guys, so it is Sunday, January 28th, and I am just sitting here. It's like noon, and my family and I are about to go for a drive, and yeah, it's just kind of a way to get me out of the house a little bit, I guess. I've got City of Fallen Angels here. I read more of it last night before I went to sleep. I have 100 pages left, exactly 100 pages left, because that was my goal last night, to get to the point where I only had to read 100 more pages of this, because, like y'all know, I have been struggling reading this. Also, this side of my face, for some reason, is very swollen, and this is the side my sinus infection and my ear infection is on. So it's really red and swollen, and it's really sensitive to the touch. Like, it hurts to touch it, so I probably shouldn't be touching it, but it's like weird. It's just super swollen, and like, I don't know, it's not feeling too good. I do not know why it's that red. It's like on fire to the touch. Like, it's like really hot, and this side of my face is fine. It's not very puffy, it's warm, or it's normal. So I don't know what the hell's going on. I'm gonna talk to my mom about it later, but yeah. So plans today are to finish City of Fallen Angels, and then to, I don't know if I told y'all this, but I started Cinder by Marissa Meyer, and I got to like page 116, and it's like okay. It wasn't my favorite thing that I read so far this month. It's like, it's, I don't know, I was expecting it to be a lot more than what it was, and I just don't think it's meeting my expectations, because everybody loves it so much, and it's just kind of been okay. I mean, I'm interested in it enough to continue reading it, but, like, I don't know. I'm not dying to pick it up, but I kind of just want to finish it, because, I mean, it won't take me long to finish, considering I've already gotten over 100 pages in, so I'm thinking that's what I'm going to pick up after today. Notice it's none of the books I had last night on my bed that I was going to read. I had, like, Salmon versus Homo Sapiens Agenda, and then I had, what else did I have? Throne of Glass, which I really want to read. I really, really need to start reading that. And then I had, what else did I have? I had Red Queen and Raven Boys. So those were all the books I had, and I'm choosing, well, I don't know. We all know that this totally could change, but my plans are to read Cinder after I read this. I'm definitely finishing this today. I've got to. I cannot have this still on my bedside table every night. I've got to finish it so I can put it away and quit suffering through this, because it has been a chore to read, which is unfortunate. And I've been told, though, that the fifth and the sixth book in this Mortal Instruments series is really good. And that this, I feel like this is kind of a filler in the novel, in the series, because this has just been dreadful. Like, nothing but useless information. And just now, on page 324, have I met the bad guy. Or bad girl. She's actually a woman. How annoying is that? Like, really? I don't know. So, I'm gonna try to read in the car, even though I get super car sick when I read. But sometimes I can read in the car. It just depends on how I'm feeling, but I'm hoping on the drive that I can finish reading it, or at least get almost done, because y'all, I seriously cannot deal with this book anymore. And then I have Clockwork Prince, which I could start today, but I don't know if I'm going to. If people keep saying it's gonna like break my heart and it's gonna like emotionally kill me. Which scares me, but also intrigues me, and I'm excited. People said it's, like, in the best way possible. Like, it's amazing, but I'm scared. but, yeah, I'm excited to read that, and I will pick up Clockwork Prince this week. I just don't know if I'm going to pick it up today, because it's, like, I have so many books on my shelf that I need to read, and I don't want to just, and also, like I said, and I think I've said this, I'm waiting for the Bane Chronicles to come, because Barnes & Noble screwed up, and it was supposed to be here last Wednesday. It is Sunday, and I still don't have it. That's okay. So, I'm gonna quit vlogging and try to sit here in my recliner until my parents get back home to take us for the drive, and then I will see y'all later. Hey, bye. Guys, so it is, I think, 8:30 in the evening, and I haven't vlogged all day. We went for a drive and then we came back here and watched a basketball game. It was the IU versus Purdue game. And then we watched some of the Royal Rumble from WWE. My dad and my brother are like big WWE fans, and they asked me to watch it with them, and I haven't watched wrestling in, wow, it's been a minute since I've watched wrestling. But yeah, so I haven't read much. I did read some more of City of Fallen Angels. Y'all know that this book is slow for me if I haven't finished it by now. I had 100 pages left this morning, and I should have honestly been done with it by now. And I wanted to watch WWE over reading this because it is that slow for me. Even the action parts are just kind of like not there for me. It's getting better, but you know, it's okay. So I'm just gonna kind of sit here and finish this off. And then I'm gonna be done with it and find something else to read. But I've gotta finish it. I'm on page 357. So I don't have much. I have like less than 70 pages left. So I can do it. But those 70 pages seem like really, really long. I might have to take a break from the Shadowhunter Chronicles for a while. Maybe that's why it's taking me so long to get through this, because like I've been reading nothing but Shadowhunter Chronicles lately. And so I might need to take a little break and then dive back into it next month sometime. But yeah, it's taken me way too long. Way, way, way too long. So yeah. Oh, by the way, this cheek right here, it went down for a while, the swelling and the redness, but as you can see, it is back with vengeance. It's very, very hot, but this cheek is warm, but it's not as hot as this one, and it's still pretty swollen, as you can see. And yeah, it's really annoying. So yeah, but that's all I gotta say. I'm tired. I need to take my medicine, but I don't want to take my medicine because I just don't like taking it sometimes. It makes me drowsy. But I gotta take it. So, I will talk to you guys later. Bye.
357.
Is that the seat left? I'm struggling. So, it is 10:30. And guess what? I still haven't finished the fucking book. Okay, God, I choked. I'm on page 375. I can do this. This has been the hardest book I have ever read. It's not hard to read. It's just killing me. And there's action! Oof. Okay, I might need to take a day or two. I've read, this will be my 19th book. I would like to get to 20 this month. That wasn't my goal to begin with, but it would be kind of cool to read 20 books. Now at this point, I'm thinking I need to take a couple days to not read, because I don't want to blame this on the Mortal Instruments series. Okay, first of all, it is a little bit its fault. Let's just be honest. Like, probably half, I'm going to say 50% of the reason it's taken me so long to read this is because of the book itself. However, this part that I'm reading on is actually quite interesting and action-packed, and I like it. But I think the other 50% is the fact that I've read so much this month, the fact that I am very, very exhausted, and I don't know if I've said this in the vlogs yet, but, okay, so when, y'all know I went to the hospital about 3-4 weeks ago, that I was in the hospital. When I get released, because they treat me so well there, and because they really, really help bring down the inflammation from the Crohn's, I am really, really okay for like 3 or 4 weeks, but then I start to get really sick again. In the past 2-3 days, which is why I've skipped a couple days with vlogs, I have been very sick. So like not eating, a constant pain, a lot of tears, a lot of nausea, a lot of everything. Stuff that I won't even get into because it's super personal and just not something that I care to share, honestly. But just a lot of bad stuff has been happening, and it's made me feel really bad. So I'm going to say that's 50%. The other 50% of the problem that I'm having trouble with, the fact that I'm so exhausted and tired. So I'm not wanting to blame everything on the book, because honestly, once you get past page 250, it gets pretty good. So yeah, but I'm going to finish it now. I'm going to sit here. The next time I vlog, I will be telling y'all that I finished this book. And the reason I got distracted this past time is because it was the first female Royal Rumble on WWE. And I had to watch that. Even though I don't watch WWE anymore, I had to watch the first female Royal Rumble. Like, that was just, like, I grew up watching WWE. It was something I loved. And the divas were always my favorite to watch because, I mean, you know, I'm a girl, and I was watching my fellow women out there kicking ass, and I was like, hey, that looks cool, and women can do that, that's cool, they can do all the things that the guys are doing, and I just loved watching that, so, yeah, it meant a lot to me, so I decided to watch it, so I'm not angry for watching it, choosing to watch that instead of reading this, because, I mean, it was cool. Oh, and y'all, Clary is so annoying. Okay, she screams more than anybody I know. If there was a drinking game for how many times this woman screamed at the sight of anything, I would be drunk as hell right now. Like, she screams over everything. She has screamed 3 times in just the past like 20 pages, and I'm like, why do you keep screaming? What is wrong with you? She's smart, and she's like, She does do some things sometimes that are impressive, like that thing when Jace had the rune drawn on his chest that made him, like, be possessed by the demon, mother of demons or whatever, and she, like, cut him there to, like, stop the rune. That was pretty cool, okay? That was smart, that was intelligent, but, like, her screaming every 2 seconds when she sees anything, like, oh my gosh, there's a doorknob. Oh my god! Scream! Like, stop. Clary, stop. Stop. She's just screaming all the time. She gets scared at anything. And she's, like, so weepy. And, like, in her inner monologue, like, in her head when she's thinking about Jace, it's so cheesy and obnoxious. And I really need to quit giving Clary a hard time. I know a lot of y'all really love her. And I like her. Don't love her. But she just, she annoys me. She just does. I can't explain it. Like, I just can't explain my, I don't know. But I'm going to keep reading. I'm going to see if Jace can beat this woman's ass. Maybe Clary can get a few swings in. Hopefully Isabella comes in and she can kick ass, because I love Isabelle. Oh, I wish Isabelle was the main character and not Clary. Okay, I'm going to go.
So I am done with City of Fallen Angels. And it still took me quite a while to finish it. I had like 10 pages left or something, and I stopped and went and talked to my mom. I think I'm just like in a reading slump, and I just don't want to read right now. But I finished it, and it was actually, the ending was pretty good. It left on a pretty big cliffhanger, and I'm very curious to see what City of Lost Soul is going to be like. But first, I've got to read Clockwork Prince. I don't know when I'm gonna pick up Clockwork Prince. I don't think it's gonna be this week. It might be, I don't know, but right, definitely not tomorrow. I'm taking a break from the Shadowhunter Chronicles. I might not even read tomorrow. I might take a break for a little while, like a day or two, and just not read. I say that now, and I'll want to read tomorrow, so. But as of right now, I'm just kind of like sitting here, just not wanting to read, so yeah. But it was a good book. It was really creepy, and I liked it. Okay, I know I said in my previous clip that Clary screams a lot. There were certain things when she screamed that I could totally understand. I would scream. Like, there was, like, really creepy things that happened in, like, the final scenes in this book. Like, really, really creepy things. Like, snakes coming out of Lilith's eyes. Like, that was weird. Like, I totally understand that. But some of the things she'd scream at, like... No, she just screamed a lot in this book,
to me. I don't know. But yeah, so also, okay, I know people probably think this is like super romantic when Jace like speaks a different language to her, and like it's like, and it's not that it's he's speaking a different language that's cheesy to me. It's just like the words that he's quoting, it's just so cheesy. Like, I don't know. Maybe I'm just not a super big romantic. I'm like not at all. My brother is, and my mom is. Me and my dad are like not romantics. Like when we're watching movies, my mom and my brother will sit there and go, oh, when like the guy says something super, super like corny and romantic to the girl. And my dad and I sit there and look at each other like we share a look and we're just like, gross. That is so stupid. And I don't know why I'm like that, but I just am. So when he says stuff like that to her, or when she says stuff to him, and I'm just like, that is so bad. So I'm just like, I don't know. I like romantic novels, and there's certain things that I do find really sweet when couples talk, but there's other things where I'm just like, Jesus, that's bad. So that, I just had a couple times in this book when Jace and Clary would be talking to each other, and I'd just be like, Lord have mercy. But yeah, the book was good. I liked it. It was not the best one. I'm gonna give it a 3 out of 5 stars, because 250 pages were just boring and I didn't care too much about it. And then another reason I'm giving it a 3 out of 5 stars instead of like a 4 is because I just felt like some of it, even towards the end when it started to get good, there was just too much cheese factor in Clary and Jace's relationship. And there was not enough Alec and Magnus. I got some of their relationship towards the end, but I wanted way more than what they gave me. I wanted more Isabel, and I like Simon more when he's with Isabel. And yeah, there was just too much screaming. And it wasn't even just Clary. Other characters would just scream at anything. And it's always the women. The guys never scream. And I'm just like, what is that? But yeah, it was just okay though. I enjoyed it towards the end. And even in the beginning, I wasn't hating it. Like, it wasn't like it was awful. I just was bored. So I think a 3 is a pretty good rating. I don't want to give it a 1 or a 2 because it really wasn't bad. It just wasn't great either. So that is my final rating for this for now. Watch me change the rating because we all know I'm so indecisive. But it was okay. I'm going to go ahead in today's vlog. I hope you guys liked it. And I will see y'all later.